Dave, form versus intensity, what do you think?
Form versus intensity? I'm all for it. Yeah. where can I get some? I don't understand the nature of the question.
You get ripped a lot for that. What do you think about that?
I think every comment that's put up ripping me or tearing me new cavities is both uncalled for and correct. Yeah. There's nothing that I'm not aware of. When someone makes a comment, I can't, you know, Dave's rounding his back on his deadlift. Yeah, that's something to definitely pay attention to. But again, you have to take it within the context. So, I mean, if I'm rounding my back on a deadlift and it's, 50% of my one rep max, that's something I'm going to be like, why the hell am I doing that? You know, correct it and get into good habits. But if it's something where I'm going for a new, you know, personal record and, you know, I round my back or do a little ratchet to get it, that's me sacrificing form for intensity. But at the same time, I obviously wouldn't want to practice that way. You know, I mean, it's the kind of thing where you sacrifice your form to get the result, but it's not the standard. You don't want to live there. You just want to kind of visit. How you doing? I come here every couple months and then go back home.
And when you're at the certs and you guys have the WOD after the end of day one, usually, how do you know then with a normal person, when you're watching someone, like if you think they should scale down or if they should, you know, slow down or stuff like that?
There's a lot of stuff. You can see if you watch them move and you know with a PVC pipe they can move very well, and you're watching them with a barbell and it looks like a train wreck, and this is rep number one, probably scale them down. You can get a good idea by when you watch them kind of go through their first couple reps if this is going to be a feasible weight for them or not. And unfortunately, we don't really know these people very well, so we can kind of gauge based on what we observe out of them, their body type, and the kind of strength that they demonstrate. But it's not an exact science, and sometimes you have to go on the fly and change things. You know, sometimes in the middle of the workout, we got to say, okay, you know, this is too much. Let's strip off the bumpers and give you the barbell, because we don't want anyone to get hurt. And I think, you know, you can still teach the concept of intensity with a barbell. You can teach the concept of intensity with a PVC. Just fucking go faster. But yeah, I mean, you just have to keep an eye out on whoever's going. That answer your question, Ian?
It does.
Does that satisfy your question?
It does.
Excellent.
It's both. In anything in life that needs speed and needs to be done well, you need both. It's not one or the other. You don't work on one or the other. You work on both. And it's really hard for people to, I think, differentiate the importance of one or the other in their head and also put them together. So it's both. And what sums it up for me the best is thinking about typing, because everybody has typed, or everybody types emails and texts and all that. And so you just say, well, do you want to text faster, or do you want to text something that actually makes sense? It's like, oh, well, I kind of would like both. Well, yeah, exactly. Same thing with a clean. Like, I want it to look pretty, plus I want it to go fast. And where that works out for each individual athlete is going to be based on a whole lot of stuff, but we want both. In the end, it's interesting how brilliance at the basics, regardless of what you're doing, is the recipe for success. I mean, whether it's fighting, wrestling, the clean and jerk, if you don't have the basics, it doesn't matter what else happens. Like, you need to get the basics down, and it resonates with everybody. I mean, it's also seen on the level ones when people show up and you can tell they're excited and they want to learn all kinds of new stuff and CrossFit and this and that, and the first thing we go over is the air squat, and everybody, almost to a person, like, I'm all set, I got air squats, we do air squats a lot, I'm all set. And then their eyes when they come back from the first squat group is just like, holy cow, I didn't know there was that much in the air squat. And I find that same enthusiasm and excitement comes from everybody, to include people that don't go to level ones, people that showed up at my garage or showed up at a gym. They're equally as excited to look and learn about the basics, regardless of where they are in that fitness realm. So it's pretty cool.